The next live broadcast, which is somewhat of a podcast, it's a video podcast. It's actually the market update for December. Again, these numbers are compiled at another time in the distant past. Go a little Star Wars-esque on this, but essentially, the reason I bring that up is because a lot of people say, what's going on with the market? What's going on, Charles? So I'll tell them exactly what's going on in the market, except it's not what they're hearing. And the reason there's a disconnect is because when the numbers are compiled and when they are actually put out, and it takes a full month, obviously, for it to be compiled and then be published, we're already about 45 days behind. Okay, so these are lagging indicators, as they say in the business realm, and the leading indicators are the open houses, the amount of buyer referrals, the amount of people placing offers, okay? So I'm gonna go over the market update, and then I'm also gonna go into, this is what I feel that the market's actually is doing, and ironically enough, I've been saying it, I don't know, for a while. I have a really good pulse on the market because you get this temperature gauge. This is the best way that you can explain it is New York City yesterday was 42 degrees on average, okay? I don't know what it was, but just call it 42 degrees. But then you also have someone that is saying, how is it right now, okay? So it's kind of buying clothes and dressing for the temperature right now as opposed to in the past. And it's the same thing with the real estate market is, do you want to know the lagging indicators? Yeah, it's good historically to compare. It's also good over time to compare. And obviously across time, you have a nice chart that you can see, is it trending down? Is it trending up? Is it trending flat? And ironically enough, we're going to be talking about that it's flat right now, which is ironically really good. Okay. Ironically, it's really good. I've been saying it for a while most agents, maybe, hopefully, potentially have been saying that it's been a buyer's market. Okay. And that's been very apparent from last year, right around April. Okay. And the reason at that time is there was a flood of inventory. Inventory just bombarded the marketplace. And when you bombard people with that many options, they just go into the paradox of choice, which is they don't make a decision. When you offer someone so many choices, they just say, well, I guess I'll wait. And then they have been waiting. And ironically enough, the people that are entering the marketplace are completely new. Okay. I'm meeting someone at 12:15 that's completely new entering the marketplace as a buyer. I got two referrals. They are completely new and have not been looking for a while, okay? That's completely, and then we have a showing today. It's an off-market transaction. We were introduced to them on Saturday, okay? So essentially all the people that are entering the marketplace are completely new. That's really good for the market because the people that have been in the market have not purchased. A lot of the buyers have not purchased. They have not taken advantage of this great market. So ironically enough is you have all of the numbers supporting that it's a buyer's market. 7 out of the 8 quarters, the pricing has been going. The interest rates are crazy low. The S&P 500 hit an all-time high. It's insane to see that rise this year. It's up 26% according to Eric, the guy that, you know, obviously we work together. So let's go over the numbers. Manhattan, down 4%. Okay, again, these are lagging indicators. Down 4%, it's the same as it's pretty much been, is that it's been sliding all from last year, again, because there's so much inventory. New homes entering the marketplace, this is very interesting, and of course, these are year over year. New homes entering the marketplace is 12% less than it was last year. So there will be a time where the amount of inventory is equilibrium to the amount of buyers out there. And when the amount of inventory, so in other words, the amount of demand, which are buyers, meets the amount of supply, you now have an equilibrium. Okay, that's a healthy marketplace. Right now, you have a lot of supply and not as much demand for that supply. Days on the market is down from last year at this time. I'm sorry, last month from this time, it's down about 13 days. That's good. So that means homes that enter the market It takes 13 days less, which is about 2 weeks, to go into contract. Brooklyn, it's flat again. Okay, I'll talk about the significance. This is very significant. The amount of new homes from last year is down 13%. The amount of new homes entering the marketplace is down 13%. The days on the market is roughly the same as it was last month, which is 65 days. 65 days is still a healthy marketplace in Brooklyn. Right around 3 months is when you start teetering. So Manhattan is above the 3 month mark, is where you start teetering on, yeah, what are we doing here? Queens, again, just like in Brooklyn, sales are flat. Okay. New homes entering the marketplace in Queens are up. I would say that's mainly due to all the new buildings that are going up in Queens. It's just an amazing sight to be seen. If you're taking the Long Island Railroad and you look north and you see all the cranes that are going up in Long Island City, it's amazing. Obviously, that whole area over there, if you bought many years ago, is probably going to be the new Williamsburg or, you know, downtown Brooklyn that is right now. Okay. Days on the market is right around, this is Queens, days on the market is 68, which is pretty much in line with what it's always been. And again, the new homes. So why am I bullish on Brooklyn being flat on the sales pricing for the second month in a row? Queens, flat for the second month in a row. Manhattan, yes, it's down. Manhattan always has more inventory. There are always usually longer days on the market because there is more inventory, so there are more options. But this is the very good thing about the market, is the only time you know the bottom is when it's in the rearview mirror. The only time you know the bottom is when it's behind you and you say, oh, that was the bottom. That's when I should have bought. The only time you know the top is when you say, wow, pricing is decreasing. I should have sold. Okay? You can't time the market precisely, but you can come within 1 to 2 percentage points. I've been saying this for a while. When you have 2 months in a row that the sales are flat, I'm not saying it has went down and it's flat and it's going to go up. But when you see that stabilization, that's what I'm seeing. I'm seeing a stabilization in the marketplace. And this is the reason being, is that we track the amount and call the amount of homes that come off the market. And we ask them, we say, what are we looking to do? Are you looking to relist it? Are you looking to rent it out? Or are you going to keep it off the market? And two things have been happening. Keep it off the market or rent it out. In a bullish market, all of those homes that come off the market, they're going to relist it with another agent. Okay, right now, the owners are not that bullish. Okay, when they're not that bullish, they don't flood the inventory. In other words, they don't put their home on the market, which is good because right now we need less homes on the market. But for the last 3 months, it has been insane amount of homes coming off the market. There have been days where there's 50 homes and then the next day, 60 homes coming off the market. And when you're talking about new inventory or total inventory, that adds up over the course of a couple of months, having hundreds of homes come off the market and not get relisted. Okay, so when you have that, and again, the rental pricing right now is insane. We have reached another high. It is up 4% in Manhattan. Okay, you put a home on the market at no fee and it's at the right price, it's gonna rent within a week, not even sometimes a day. Okay, we have two homes that we're gonna be putting on the market. We put it at the right price, we put it up as no fee. It's going to rent. This is typically not a good time to rent, right in between Thanksgiving and Christmas. Actually, it's right before Thanksgiving that I'm filming this. But during the holidays is not the best time because nobody really moves. Their leases are not up. But because there's not really good rental inventory, what are we going to do? So I tell everyone, to owners that are looking to sell, why don't we rent it out? Why don't we keep it off the market? And this is the time that you need to buy. I don't care if you miss it within 1 to 2 percentage points to bottom. The next 12 months, right before the election, is going to be a slow time. If you're a seller, the best time to put your home on the market is going to be mid-February to about Memorial Day. Okay? If you put it on after Memorial Day, not ideal. okay, because we're going to be talking about the election, or other people are, because I don't really care, but other people are going to be talking about the election, and everyone's going to be worried about whatever, and then 2021 is going to hit, and then you're going to have completely new buyers. The election is over. Manhattan has already went through its downturn, and then it's going to start. It's not going to be a hockey stick, but we are going to hit a stabilization phase, stabilization. Okay, then you have a little momentum going up, and then you have growth. Okay, I went through this in 2009. It was really bad elsewhere in the United States. In Manhattan, it hit us around 2010. Then there was a stabilization phase, which is roughly 3 to 4 months, maybe 2 quarters. And then there's a growth phase, and that growth phase hit Manhattan 2011 to 2016, right around 2017, and then from 2017 to about right now, it's been in flux, okay? It hit Brooklyn a little bit later, it hit Queens a little bit after that, but in Manhattan, we've been sliding for quite some time. If you are holding onto a property right now, I would highly recommend that we rent it out, put in a tenant for a year or a year and a half, and then we put it on in 2021 or 2022. I know that's a long time away. I know people can't look that far ahead. However, if you're looking to maximize your price, that is the only time. There will be more buyers. It'll be bullish. And ironically enough, it's been said time and time again by the smartest investors in the market is when everyone is bullish is when you sell. When everyone is bearish is when you buy. And it's the exact same thing in real estate. So if you're looking to maximize the amount of money that you're going to make over the next 7 years, you have to buy in the next 12 months, okay? It could be even the next 14 months, 15 months, maybe 2 years, okay? But after that, I personally would wait until maybe 9 years out. You know, for us, you know, if you want to know our business trajectory is we want to get through, stabilize our business here at BPI. Then in 2021, we take off, we build up a bunch of reserves. And then in the next recession, which is going to be probably 2029, is that we pick up multifamily homes and then we have cash flow. And I'm more bullish on real estate than ever before because you can't time. The timing real estate is a little bit easier than timing stock because stock can literally overnight, earnings report comes and it skyrockets and then you miss it. Nothing happens like that in real estate, okay? You could time it within maybe 2 to 3 quarters, okay? And again, even then, you're going to say, oh, I missed the top or I missed the bottom. But ironically enough, as long as you buy at the right time, at the right price, the right investment, and you sell at the right time, you will make money, okay? You will make money. I'm very bullish on Manhattan. The higher end is completely different. That has years of inventory, years. There are going to be a lot of struggling buildings. But if you're a landlord, if you're an investor, this is the time that you pick up an apartment, you put in a tenant, and the reason being is that if the rental market is good right now, okay, when the sales market is not, usually they coincide a little bit, but they're not coinciding at all right now. The sales market is completely different than the rental market, okay? So if you're an investor, you're making really good returns on your rents, okay? If you're an owner, you are not making a good time right now, and the reason being is that it's a slower time between the holidays, there aren't as many buyers, and the amount of competition, which is other inventory that people are going to see, and I see this, okay? I see this. I'm at an open house, and I say, oh, what have you seen today? I have 5 things before this, I have 5 things after this. That's a lot, okay? That's a lot. That's too much, honestly. That's too much. So if you guys have any questions, obviously, shoot me an email, charles@boatenston.com. That is the best way to look at the market is through the scope of lagging indicators, which is over time, and then real life temperature, which is a professional real estate agent that is in the marketplace and making 2.5 hours of calls a day, talking to, you know, dozens of people every single day that are in the market that are real buyers and or real sellers or investors, and they have a really good pulse of, I saw this home, I really like this home, but I'm not gonna make an offer. That's hesitancy. That's not buyer confidence. Okay. And I understand a lot of buyers are hesitant because there's not a lot of buyers that are entering the marketplace. But if you historically look at the people that make the most amount of money, they're the renegades that buy at not a good time, or they sell when it's on fire. Okay. So if you guys have any questions, leave in the comments below. And